Hello guys. Well, it's Sunday afternoon. Late Sunday afternoon. The sun would like to go down. It's over there, trying to go down. And I am walking in the Tuileries garden. It's an excellent thing to do on a Sunday afternoon. Go walking in the garden. Yes. Go walking in the garden. Probably the sun is completely wrong for this, but my, you know, I think there's a spot in New York Central Park where the buildings come up next to the park that's sort of like this, sort of. But of course, Central Park is only 150 years old. This park is 600 years old. Look, see that lion eating a crocodile. I keep thinking what terror. A friend of mine lives here. He's from Tijuana. His name is Jose, or Pepe. And until today, I was thinking, oh my God, what if I run into him? What will I say? Blah, 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 blah. But I've been in contact with him, and he's gone on holiday. Still emails, of course, but he won't be back for a few days. So I don't need to worry about running into him in the park, do I? What a lovely day. Perfect time to just sit by the fountain. And think about all the lost opportunities. And all of the great opportunities we have that we take hold of. And get love. From our family, from our friends, or even from the people we work with. Respect and partnership. Those two are a kind of love. I'm not sure if I'll see the trees turn or not. They're beginning to show a little bit of brown. But I don't think this will be a spectacular season of autumn leaves in Paris. Maybe it will surprise me. Maybe it will turn out to be, after all, a beautiful fall, after all. Maybe. And yet, when I think that I might have died without seeing Paris. Such a thought is disturbing to an artist like myself. It doesn't matter if people bitch at me because I talk about the love I have lost. It doesn't matter to me if I can't stay overnight in the Ritz or the Hotel de Louvre. But it does matter to me to be able to walk in the park over there. Is the refreshment stand. Remember the refreshment stand at the end of the earth? This is the refreshment stand at the beginning of the earth. In the gardens of the Tuileries, there are places to rest, places to think, and places to walk. And places for children to play. Places for children to play. Although it is recommended that they stay out of the water. Now here's a chair. It looks like I sat in it. Ah, you can see there are some leaves here. More leaves than we get in California, at least. Some color coming through the afternoon sunlight. Two 200 years ago, in the great empire, the princes and princesses, the courtiers, and the ladies of court would have come to sit on this marble bench beside the pond. But those days are gone, for the pond is now clearly interdit. We are not supposed to go in the water, nor should we sit on the marble benches. This reminds me of what I've seen in the past few years happen to the Maya and Aztec ruins in Mexico. When I first went to Chichen Itza, you could still climb the Great Pyramid. I understand that is no longer the case. Things change, you know. And yet, they still remain the same. Nowadays, we are supposed to sit in these pleasant garden seats and not go in the water. 300 years ago, the courtiers were to sit on the marble bench and even stand on the edge of the water, but not, I repeat, go into the water. M-I-H-O.